Hey, good morning YouTube. So this is the saddle and seat post off my Monster Cross bike. This is an X-Fusion HiLo dropper seat post. So it's a 27.2 millimeter, which fits my Monster Cross frame. Common on road bikes to have the smaller diameter. I think the mountain bikes are 30 point something millimeters. But anyway, the way this works is you have a lever here. They also make a handlebar lever and a cable that you can attach here, but I kind of like the lever under the seat, and you can drop the seat post. This is a 100 millimeter drop here. So I put this seat post on probably 4 years ago, 5 years ago, and I really like it for riding up in the mountains on the more of the mountain bike trails, because you can lower your seat post and get a lot lower center of gravity and just get more maneuverability on the bike for steep descents. And then you can flip the lever and pull the post up. Problem I was having is I would pull it up, and then as soon as I got on the saddle, it would drop down about that far, and there was just no way you could keep it all the way fully extended. And what had happened is over the years, the oil that's in here had leaked out around the seals just a little bit. I mean, it was never a major leak. It would just be a drop every week or two, but over time, there was that much oil had leaked out, so it would drop down that far. And I guess the way these work is there's two chambers here. There's oil in the smaller post, and then there's a similar volume in the larger section here. So when you go down, you're pumping the oil from here into here, and when you go up, it's taking the oil from here and moving it up there. And then this is your valve, and when it's shut, the oil here can't flow out the bottom. But anyway, I needed to refill the oil, so if you go in here, there's a Schrader valve. So you need a 10 millimeter socket to get that out. Let me just show you that real quick. So yeah, there's your Schrader valve. And I didn't really want to take this all the way apart, but what I found that worked for a refill technique is I took the valve core out here. So I have a valve core remover. Take that out, and I ended up pumping all the old fluid out. So to do that, you can just invert the post, and then you hold the lever in, and you just pump this like a tire pump and pump all the old oil out. And then what I did to refill it is I compressed it all the way, and then I took a syringe here. I think this is about 50 milliliters, and I have a clear tube that fits over the Schrader valve. And I found if I filled this all the way to the top and then used this like a syringe and just pulled the saddle down, sucking the oil into the top here, and I kind of cycled it a few times to get all the air bubbles out, and that fills this entire thing with oil, which is too much. So then what I did was I inverted this in my oil. I used some 10 weight. X-Fusion recommends 5 weight, but I've seen some other articles where they recommend either 10 or 15 weight. So I thought I would try 10. It doesn't get terribly cold here, so I figured maybe a little thicker oil might help with the slight weeping I'm getting here. But anyway, what I did was pulled the valve core out, or the valve core was still out. I tipped it upside down, and then I pumped down about halfway on this. So I basically pumped out about half the oil like that, and I kept repeating. I would pump some oil out, put the valve core in, and then you cycle this a few times inverted like this, holding the lever down, kind of pump the oil around, and then I would see how far down it would go. And I kept repeating that until I could, you know, like I say, I didn't quite get clear to the bottom here. there's still a little bit of shaft that I don't have, so I've got it slightly over full, but I figure that way, as a little bit of oil leaks out over a year or two, it'll come down here. You kind of have to turn them right side up and pump it a few times to get the oil in the right place. But that was how I filled this back up, is just I overfilled it here, and then it took about three tries, and I ended up going about halfway down. So I would pump about half the oil out there and then put the valve core back in and just keep repeating until you can collapse it fully. Now, the one thing I still have to do is repressurize this. I think it goes up to 25 or 26 PSI. Right now, I don't have any air pressure in it, but since I use the lever on the saddle, I can just pull the seat post up. In fact, that's what I've been using for the last, oh, probably 3 years, because I think I lost all the pressure in here. So I don't really miss not having the air pressure. But I think I'm going to pick up a shock pump so I can pump this up properly and just see how it works with the air. I can send this in for a rebuild, but the rebuild overhaul cost on one of these is something like $100, $150. I mean, if it just leaks a little bit of oil and I have to put in, you know, I can buy a pint of oil for $10, and if that'll last me for 10 years without having to rebuild this, that's a pretty good deal in my book. You know, a little bit of leakage isn't too bad. You know, I'll wait until this thing doesn't work, and then I might send it in for a rebuild. Let's put the valve cover cap back on there. Anyway, that's how to refill the oil in one of these. It's a little bit of a mess. You got oil and greasy hands, and fortunately I didn't film any of that. I was kind of just playing with this thing for about half an hour. You basically just use the seat post as a big syringe and suck the oil in here until it's full, and then you just keep pumping a little bit of oil out until you can compress it all the way. Yeah, if I put my weight on, I can get down to about there. So I've got that much too much oil, but I figure that was close enough. It'll leak out over time and fix itself. And you can see, even without air pressure, I get some extension. I just don't get the last inch. But yeah, that's how to refill one of these HiLo seat posts. So maybe I'll do an update video when I get the shock pump, and we'll see about putting some air pressure in here. But I think for now that is going to work for me. So yeah, you don't need a whole bunch of tools, just a 10 millimeter socket to get the valve cap off, some sort of funnel, or I used a syringe with a piece of tubing to get the oil in. And yeah, that seems to do the trick. So I'm going to get this back on the bike and take it out for a test ride. So if anybody has any tips on servicing these things, I found an article, an old article, that I might try to put up on my webpage. See if I can do that. If so, I'll put that link in the video description. There's also the servicing information on the X-Fusion website, but it basically says no user serviceable parts, so don't even attempt to service one of these. But I think you can do a few things. And like I say, I'll probably run this until it completely fails, doesn't work anymore, and then I'll go ahead and send it in to get professionally rebuilt. But for now, I think a little bit of oil and it's back to working normally. That's all I was looking to do. Anyway, if you have any suggestions on working on one of these, post up in the comment section down below, and I'll put any follow-up videos over here on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.